In this screencast, we're trying to determine which of three different reactors, a 20-liter PFR, a 100-liter CSTR, or a 100-liter PFR, will have the highest consumption rate of the reactant, A, at the reactor outlet for this first order A to B isomerization type reaction. First, we can compare the two PFRs. So we have a 20-liter PFR, or plug flow reactor, and a 100-liter plug flow reactor. And the one with the higher consumption rate at the exit, we're going to expect is going to be the one with the higher concentration at the exit. Since for a first order reaction, the rate is directly proportional to the concentration. And we're going to expect that if we have a larger reactor, that we'll therefore be able to convert more of our component A to B. And so for the 100 liter reactor, the concentration of A is going to be less than the 20-liter reactor. For that reason, we can immediately neglect the fact that the 100-liter PFR, it's not possible that that is going to have the lowest rate among the three. Based on this, we know that the answer is either the 20-liter PFR or the 100-liter CSTR will have the highest concentration at the outlet of the reactant, and therefore the highest reaction rate at the outlet. All right, so let's compare these two cases. So starting with a 20-liter PFR, we actually aren't given all the information about the plug flow reactor. So we'll write out the material balance for component A in this reactor in order to try to solve for some of our unknown quantities, and in particular, to try to solve for this value of the outlet concentration of the PFR. We can write down the mole balance as follows, where the derivative of the molar flow rate of component A with respect to the volume is equal to the reaction rate of A, which is equal to, again, this first order dependence of negative K times CA. All right, we're told that this is isothermal, so K is just a constant. And since it's isothermal and there's a constant number of moles in this system because there's an A to B type reaction, we'll assume there's also a constant pressure in this system. And therefore, we can assume that the volumetric flow rate through the system is the same. And that's going to allow us to replace this variable FA with the volumetric flow rate through the system times the concentration of A, assuming that constant volumetric flow rate. In other words, that the volumetric flow rate throughout is equal to the volumetric flow rate at the entrance of the reactor. With that assumption, we are going to do this substitution, and we're going to be able to move out that volumetric flow rate at the inlet conditions out of the derivative because we're assuming it's a constant, and that is equal to negative KCA. All right, and now we'll just need to divide both sides of the equation by the concentration of A and multiply both sides of the equation by dV to get an integrable form. And so we'll do that here. And this will be our differential equation that we're going to end up solving and integrating from the initial concentration of A to the final concentration of A at the exit, which is what we actually want to solve for in this case. And that's equal to the negative of the reaction rate constant divided by the inlet volumetric flow rate integrated over dV. And again, these terms are just constants, as we've already said, because we have fixed temperature and fixed volumetric flow rate. When we integrate the left-hand side, we'll get the classical logarithmic form. And so when we plug that in and apply our integration limits, then we'll get the following equation. We get this exponential decay function as a function of volume. Here the volume is known as 20 liters, but negative k over v naught is not known. We're going to leave that as an unknown for now and turn our analysis to compare how the concentration, what function we can solve for that outlet concentration using a material balance for the 100 liter CSTR. And so we get that at steady state, the molar flow rate of component A in minus the molar flow rate of component A out plus the rate of generation of component A in that volume is equal to zero at steady state. We're going to do the same substitution that we did above, that we can replace molar flow rate with a volumetric flow rate times a concentration. We'll also substitute in for the reaction rate in terms of a concentration. And so that's going to give us the following equation, where now we can solve for our concentration of A in terms of some of these variables, which we'll do here. And so we end up with an expression for the concentration at the outlet of the 100 liter CSTR as being equal to Ca naught times this ratio here that again involves this ratio of K over the volumetric flow rate in the final answer, just as we had for the plug flow reactor. Right, we have that K over V naught. We see that for both of these two expressions, that the concentration of A at the outlet is linearly proportional to the concentration of A at the inlet. And so that's not going to affect either concentration differently, but we get a different functional form that's multiplied by that initial concentration. And the fact that we have these two different functional forms, if you play around with the unknown values of these K over V naught, what you'll quickly see is that which concentration is higher, whether it's the concentration at the outlet of the CSTR or the PFR, is going to depend actually on that value of K over V naught. It will turn out, if K over V naught has a value of around 0.13 reciprocal liters, if we plug that value for these lumped constants in for K over V naught to both equations, that we will see that we'll get that the concentration at the exit of the PFR is equal to the concentration of A at the exit of a CSTR. And if we look at values less than 0.13 reciprocal liters, then the concentration of A at the outlet of the PFR is actually higher. And this furthermore means that the rate of consumption is higher. And if K over V naught is greater than 0.13 reciprocal liters, then it turns out that we'll solve for the concentration of A at the exit of the CSTR being greater than the concentration of A at the exit of the PFR. Therefore, because the rate again is directly proportional to concentration, the rate of A consumption will be higher at the CSTR exit under those conditions. And so we see that for a first order reaction, as we have in this case, or indeed for any positive order reaction, we can compare the rates at the outlet of a much smaller PFR of only 20 liters to the rate at the outlet of a larger CSTR of 100 liters. And we can't conclude for certain for these positive order reactions whether the CSTR or the PFR will have the higher concentration and therefore the higher rate. We would be able to conclude if we had looked at this in this problem that a 100 liter PFR, if we compared that to a 100 liter CSTR, would always have a lower concentration and a lower rate. But when the volumes are different, it actually depends on the value of the kinetic parameters, which one is going to have a higher outlet concentration and therefore a higher reaction rate.